Hey, Jonathan here. In today's video, we're going to take a look at how to transform this column over here to this column over here. If you're new to this channel and you're keen to learn the latest tips, tricks, and tools for working more effectively with data, please hit the subscribe button for weekly videos. Now, this is a question that comes from one of my students, Ramprasad, who's on my course, Are Tidyverse Reporting and Analytics for Excel Users? And I think this is a great question. This is something pretty typical that you like to do. So let's head straight over to R to see how we can go about doing that. I'm just going to hit Control-Shift-N to start a new worksheet here. Now, first up, I'm going to load up the library TidyQuant. Now, TidyQuant is a fantastic library written by Matt Dancho, and it's basically a wrapper for the Tidyverse library, as well as a whole bunch of financial and time series libraries and stuff as well. So this is to solve this problem, we're going to use a function from the library Zoo, which is also wrapped up inside of TidyQuant anyway. So this just loads everything for us. So to mimic the problem that Ramprasad has here, I'm just going to set this up. So I'm going to create a tuple, and I'm going to have a column called original is equal to, and let's see, he has VE4 and VE5. Okay, so VE4, and then we have a bunch of NAs, so NA, and VE5, NA. Okay, so this is what our original column looks like. Now, basically what we want to do is fill in these NAs with this value on top. So to do this, I'm going to use the mutate function. And I'm going to call the new column, let's just call it filled. And this is going to be equal to, and I'm going to use the function called na.locf. And as you can see, this comes from the Zoo library, which is automatically being loaded with TidyQuant. So I'm going to use this function here. And just so you know, LOCF stands for last observation carried forward. So that's what LOCF stands for there. And I'm just going to put in original here. And there we go. So that's basically how you solve this problem. Now, I just thought I'd quickly cover something else as well, because in this situation, this function works if we have NAs here. Now, sometimes instead of having NAs, potentially what you might have is maybe empty strings instead. So let's take a look at what that might look like. So instead of NAs here, maybe we have something like this, right? So let's just replace those with these. Okay, so if we tried this now, this function is not going to work because there's no blanks to actually fill down. So how do we go about solving this? Well, first up, we'd do one extra step on our data first. So we're going to want to do a if else. Original is equal to blank, then NA, otherwise original, right? Let's just take a look to see what that looks like there. So you can see here, by writing that code, it replaces the blanks with NAs. And now we can basically proceed to do the rest of this here. So I'll just put filled back in here is equal to this. Now that we have our NAs here, I can use pipe na.locf. And there we have it. Let's just get rid of this just to clean things up. So I hope that helps. I think it's a really fantastic question, something that you might want to do quite often. So here you go. tidyquant, fantastic library for doing this kind of operation. If you found this helpful, please leave a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.